Well, I've never been one to steer away or run from controversy. So today I want to talk to you about why I think camouflage for deer hunting is a scam and you shouldn't fall for it. Sitting here on my sofa are four distinct and different camouflage patterns and designs. And the question is, which one is best suited to hide you from the deer? So, why do I say that camouflage is a scam? I just showed you four different colors, and the question is, which one of those is the best pattern? Now, for me, I will say that I prefer my army suit. And here's the deal. To understand camouflage, you really need to understand how deer see colors, okay? Deer are red-green colorblind, like a lot of people are. They basically see red, orange, and yellow the exact same way. Which is why in November, come the gun deer hunting season, we can all wear blaze orange, sit in a tree, and get away with it. In fact, I've had deer walk right up to me, standing still and wearing blaze orange, and the deer had no clue that I was there. They basically cannot distinguish between light green and dark green. So if you're wearing green patterns, or if you're wearing patterns that have lots of various shades of green in them, you've wasted a lot of money because the deer just see a green blob. I'm not sure how they see it, but they can't distinguish between light and darks in green. And blue is a color that they see very clearly. Blue is a color, they see blue the way you and I see blaze orange if we have normal non-colorblind eyes. In fact, it has to do with the wavelengths of the colors. Deer see ultraviolets very brilliantly, so you could be wearing camo, and if your wife did the laundry, and instead of using your scent killer laundry detergent, she used the UV protective stuff, then you might be in the woods glowing like a light bulb and not even realize it. But the deer realize it. So why do I call camo a scam? Well, remember a few years ago when Sitka came out and they said basically everything should be gray, you know, we should have different gradients and scales of gray. And it was this revolutionary thing in camouflage, and people were switching over to it and spending hundreds and thousands of dollars on upgrading their camo because they had this great scientific breakthrough in understanding the way that deer see colors. Isn't it something that now, just a few years later, Sitka has released a line of forest green patterns? Well, why are you releasing forest green patterns when just a few years ago you told us that deer see in various shades of gray and gray was the best thing for camouflage? So here's the thing, guys. The big camo companies, think Mossy Oak, Real Tree, etc., they license patterns to clothing companies, and they sell that clothing to us at a significant markup. You know, the question is, if these patterns every year, you know, that deer are evolving so rapidly that we need new camo patterns every single year. It begs the question, because we know that that's not true, but if all this camo and all these changes are so necessary, how did guys like Fred Bear kill so many big bucks with what we would now consider not just primitive camo, but primitive everything? His bow is not anything that we would even look twice at if we saw it in a bargain bin at a Goodwill or a secondhand store or a garage sale. We wouldn't even look at that equipment. But here's the bottom line to all of it. Whether you choose to use expensive camo, cheap camo, secondhand camo, and there's even an argument actually for just varying solid colors, combining some khaki with some brown and then some black just to break up your human form and make it look different. There's an argument for that, but here's the bottom line. The best camouflage in the world will not make up for bad scent control and bad hunting habits, okay? If you don't know how to walk through the woods quietly, rolling your feet heel to toe, and you're just dragging your feet through the crunchy leaves, on my land, we have a road that goes back to a couple of our stands. We call it Potato Chip Alley because it's so loud and so covered with leaves. It sounds like you're walking on potato chips. But if you don't know how to walk quietly in those situations, your camo doesn't matter. If you don't know enough to not smoke a cigarette or a cigar from the tree stand, or if you go in a tree stand where the wind is not favorable to you, your $1,000 Sitka hunting gear is not gonna make a difference. If you don't understand proper stand access and accessing your stands from the edges of your property, having an outside in approach to your property, your camo really isn't gonna matter, guys. I'll tell you, for me, the camo that I have over here, I use my old army stuff probably more than anything because it's the most warm and it's the most quiet. I bought the game hide stuff this year because it has a really quiet material on the exterior. However, on the interior, because it's waterproof, it has a bit of a squeak to it when I move my arms and when I articulate in my hips. And I don't like that. I don't like that at all. So I'm probably not gonna be using that because I'm far more concerned about how it sounds than how it looks. So you just need to break up your pattern, guys. Remember, deer see all green the exact same way. So there's no reason to have 7 variant shades of green in your camo. Blue, don't hunt in blue jeans, okay? The deer are gonna see you. Be aware of your laundry detergent and the UV protective properties that it has. And just break up your pattern. Break up your pattern, okay? And then whether you're hunting 22 feet in the air or from a ground blind, if you are practicing proper scent control and noise control, then you will be successful in the woods almost regardless of your camo pattern. So, sorry if I triggered some of you, but it's just one of those things that needs to be said. And bottom line is, I love camo. I dig camo patterns. My son loves camo. So we do spend some money on camo, but it's not because I think it's gonna make me a better hunter, okay? And so practice good hunting skills, be a good shooter, a good archer, be good at practicing noise and scent discipline and proper stand access, and you will be successful in the woods regardless of your camo pattern. That's it for this video, guys. Like, subscribe, share, and we'll see you on the next one.